We want to select all the statements that are true about the fraction 23/6. Looking at the first two statements, it is an irrational number, it is a rational number. For review, the definition of a rational number is any number that can be written in the form of a over b, where a and b are integers, and b is not zero. And so because we're given the value as a fraction, we know that it is rational and is not irrational. So the second statement is true, this first statement is not true. Looking at the next two statements, as a decimal it terminates, and as a decimal it repeats. So to determine if these are true, we'll have to convert the fraction to a decimal. So remember, 23/6 means 23 divided by 6, because a fraction bar means division. So we'll set this up as long division, where we'll have 23 divided by 6. We first ask how many 6s in 23, which would be 3. 3 times 6 is equal to 18. We subtract, and notice how the difference is 5, which is less than 6, which means the 3 is correct. But because we have a remainder, and we're converting the fraction to a decimal, we now add a decimal point to the right of 23, which would be here, move it up to the quotient, and now we can add zeros to the right of the decimal point without changing the value of 23. So go ahead and put a zero here, and then move it down. So now we ask the question, how many 6s in 50, which would be 8. 8 times 6 is equal to 48. Subtract. Again, notice how the difference is 2, which is less than 6. Now we add a 0 to the hundredths place value, bring it down, and ask how many 6s in 20, which would be 3. 3 times 6 is equal to 18. Subtract. The difference is 2. Notice how this is the same difference that we had last time. Add another 0, bring it down, and we ask how many 6s in 20, which is the same question we asked last time, which we already know is 3. 3 times 6 is equal to 18. Subtract. Difference is 2. Now we should begin to recognize a pattern. If we add another 0 and then bring it down, notice how we get 20 again. And we keep asking the same question, how many 6s in 20, which again would be 3. So notice how the 3 here is going to repeat, which means 23/6 as a decimal is equal to 3.83 repeating. Notice how the bar would only go over the 3 because the 8 doesn't repeat, only the 3. So looking back at our statements, as a decimal it terminates, which is not true. As a decimal it repeats is true. The next statement, it is an approximation for pi. To determine if this statement is true, we need to remember that pi is approximately equal to 3.14, which obviously is not approximately 3.83 repeating. Therefore, it is not used as an approximation for pi. You may remember from our previous lesson that 22/7 is often used as an approximation for pi because 22/7 is approximately 3.14. The last statement, as a decimal, it is equivalent to 3.83. Well, 3.83 does not equal 3.83 repeating. Well, they would be approximately the same value. Because they're not equal, as a decimal, it is equivalent to 3.83 is not true. So two of the six statements are true. I hope you found this helpful.